Hello, and this year we have another contest winner, and it's a child, 13 years old, and because it's a contest driven in Germany for German speakings, the slide here is mostly in German, but we will explain what it is, and maybe we get some more languages or countries doing this also. My name is Reimar Bauer. I'm one of the initiators of this project. I'm also a board member of the Python Software Verband. And with me, there is also someone who has a marvelous idea how to do this that school year students are interested in Python. This is Peter Koppertz. And he says also some words about himself.
Hello, my name is Peter Koppertz, and I have developed large parts of the content from the course material, and I have held some courses and I'm very proud to see some boys and girls again who has this courses participated in this courses.
Okay, so there will be some more actors today. Then after some a little bit explanation, then we have an interview with Mika Greif. This is a winner. I just show him to you.
Okay. Mein Name ist Mika Greif. Ich bin zurzeit 13 Jahre alt und komme aus Berlin. Ich gehe auf die Bettina von Arnim und meine Hobbys sind eigentlich zurzeit Jujutsu. Und ich habe früher mal 6 Jahre Tennis in einem Verein gespielt.
Ja. Okay, so that's was in German. So that makes me it easy. We have someone you will be maybe visit tomorrow at and the next other midday. At midday there will be some training for us, and this is by Thomas Fabula. He makes us with some sports happy here. And also he is very good in translations and so. And I know he speaks a lot of languages. And he helps us today that Mika just had not so much English lessons yet, that he helps with translations. So he gives for now a short summary.
Yeah, thank you, Reimar. Thank you, Mika. Mika is 13 years old, as you understand, and he is a fan of jujutsu. This is a martial art. If you are interested in martial arts, we will have the opportunity to have tomorrow and the next 3 days some activation of your cognitive and your mental and physical health. But now back to Mika. I asked him, he was also doing 6 years tennis, and he's going to the Bettina von Arnim School here in Berlin. And now, is a question, how did you get to programming? And what was nice there and what is the next things? Wie bist du zum Programmieren gekommen?
Aufs Programmieren gekommen bin ich dadurch, dass mein Vater ein professioneller Programmierer ist und weil ich früher mal einen Roboter Mindstorm Lego hatte, den man programmieren konnte, dass er zum Beispiel nach vorne oder zur Seite fährt. Und das fand ich dann eben auch ziemlich cool und wollte dann von meinem Vater mal ein bisschen mehr in JavaScript oder C-Sharp oder was auch immer lernen.
Okay, did you understand? Du musst ein bisschen lauter reden, okay? Nochmal ganz kurz, letzten 3 Sätze.
Mein Vater ist ein professioneller Programmierer und früher hatte ich mal einen Roboter, einen Lego-Roboter in Mindstorm und den konnte man programmieren, dass zum Beispiel die Motoren nach vorne oder nach hinten fahren, zur Seite oder schießen können. Und ja, dann wollte ich natürlich etwas mehr über Programmieren lernen, habe meinen Vater gefragt und dann hat er mir ein bisschen mehr über JavaScript, Python und C-Sharp beigebracht. Da habe ich eben angefangen, ein bisschen zu programmieren, zum Beispiel so 1 plus 1 ist 2.
Okay, very good. So, His father was the man who, and of course the mother, who motivated him. He's a professional programmer. I heard about something like embedded systems or things like this, yeah? Because he mentioned Raspberry Pi. I think we have to look for a Raspberry Pi for Mika, because Raspberry Pi and Python is a very good combination. He used to program with Lego Mindstorm, with a little robot not for surveillance, but for remote control, and a little bit with JavaScript, I think. And also he told me, besides, with Unity Game Engine. Okay, but how did you notice of this competition and this Pi Move 3D? Wie hast du davon erfahren, und der Wettbewerb? Wie ist das eigentlich dazu gekommen?
Auf den Wettbewerb bin ich gekommen dadurch, dass ich und mein Vater einmal bei den Linux-Tagen in Chemnitz waren. Dort haben wir ein paar Workshops durchstöbert und dann haben wir den Peter Kopfarz kennengelernt bei dem Blender-Tutorial über Low Poly. Und dann hat er uns auch am Ende davon erzählt, dass es einen Pi-Move-Wettbewerb gibt und ich wollte den eben mal ausprobieren und zu gucken, was so alles geht.
So, it was also in Berlin at the Linux Tage. I think it was some months ago. We could have met there. I was at the Python and Plauen fair booth also. And Peter Kopatz, you already have heard him. They had contact to this competition, and he wanted to move something, and he was very interested to get something done. And he knows a little bit Blender, I think. And this is the question. Wie bist du auf Blender und Python gekommen? Und was hast du jetzt genau gemacht? Vielleicht sagst du zwei Worte zu dem Thema. What did you program and why do you use Python and Blender?
Also auf Python und Blender bin ich gekommen, dadurch, dass ich früher mal ein eigenes Spiel entwickeln wollte. Und dann habe ich eine Game Engine gesucht, die hieß dann Unity. Habe ich damit ein paar Spiele entwickelt, aber dann wollte ich natürlich auch selber eigene Objekte, zum Beispiel einen Zylinder oder so, da reinbringen. Bin dann so auf Blender gekommen. Und später, ein paar Monate später, habe ich dann gemerkt, dass Blender auch eine eigene Game Engine hat. Die habe ich dann ausprobiert und gemerkt, dass sie mit Python angetrieben wird. Und habe dann etwas Python gelernt, habe meinen Vater manchmal gefragt, wie es mit den Klassen oder mit den Threads richtig funktioniert. Und ja, so ist es dann entstanden.
So, he mentioned that he wanted to move something and he was used with Blender, I think with 2.69, but he had to switch to 2.70a, this version, because only this was running with his Python program. But he was very enthusiastic in getting some things moved, and I think he's a dynamic boy, so applause already now, I think, for him. Okay. So last question, maybe something to the technical background. Was hast du jetzt technisch gemacht im Hintergrund? Und ich sag mal, was kann man noch verbessern? Und wie sieht die Zukunft aus? Was könntest du dir vorstellen, was man noch tun sollte? How is the future? Maybe you can give an outlook.
Also verbessern mit meinem Skript könnte ich noch, dass die Tropfen, also von den Eiszapfen die Tropfen, auch realistisch runterfallen und nicht einfach nur die ganze Zeit dieselbe Geschwindigkeit haben, sondern am Anfang langsamer sind, dann immer schneller werden. Oder zum Beispiel, dass die Eiszapfen eine realistische Form haben. Und verbessert habe ich in dem letzten Update noch, dass zum Beispiel Sounds, sobald ein Tropfen runterfällt, ein Sound kommt, der dann, und wenn er unten angekommen ist, wieder ein Sound, sowas wie im Platschen. Und ja.
Okay, so you will see what he have done, his creative work. He want to improve it, of course, with sound, with more dynamic moving icicles or falling drops. He wants to get more physics into this whole stuff, I understand, and he wants to make it mostly realistic. But I asked him, how long did you program and how did you had time to solve this problem? It's not a problem, it's a challenge. It's only 3 weeks. 3 weeks. 3 Wochen. Ist das richtig? Super. Thank you, Mika. Ralf. Bitte hier geblieben, es gibt ja noch die Preisverleihung.
Now, thank you very much. Nice interview. And please take a seat. So, and you also. Thank you.
Yeah, now you have heard how much interested such a project can be. And maybe we just want to tell a bit more about what it is, and maybe you have childs or you know childs, and next year maybe we can have an international contest or also again a German contest. The idea is we need some platform or some program where when we want to use Python on a computer, then we have several platforms and it's not so easy to get the same version of Python on each platform easily. But if you do this with Blender, there's no problem. And, Blender has a very good documentation also, and it has a Python API. So the contest is about to use now Blender, but don't click or use any of these buttons tools, make everything in Python, and then just do by your Python program a movie. And the movie you have to submit, and also the Python program, and also a screencast and some other things. And so after the submission, your Python program must make the movie, so that was done by Mika also. And this is how this wonderful Blender IDE looks like. And Peter wants to explain a little bit more about this. And you see also, yeah, there's a movie in it.
At the first, I have two interesting news. The first one is not on, has nothing to do with Blender and this contest. We have found in a library an old paper. Here is it is, the origin. And you know, we have the anniversary of William Shakespeare this year. And you know the famous words, to be or not to be. And that isn't true anymore. On this paper, I can read, to use Python or not to use Python. This is the question. And this is a maxim in our contest. And the second interesting news is that we have to put Python on every operating system. And this is not true for all operating systems by default. And we have to put a Trojan horse on the operating system to get Python to work with little effort. And so we decided to use Blender. And if you didn't already know, in Blender is integrated a Python. It is the newest Python version, 3.4. And it's not visible in the first place. You have to switch some windows, and then you have an IDE, as you can see here, as an example. You have an editor. You don't need to install Eclipse or such some. You have a Python console you can use directly, and in the end, you can construct your own worlds, not only textual hello world. You can this hello world print in 3D and other nice stuff. And this is the goal, to have fun and to move in the end all the objects. But you can do really serious things in science and in all wie sagt man Fächer in den Schulen in all in math in chemistry in art at school you can learn Python and combine the programming experience with other themes at school. Here
Ist der Film schon abgelaufen? Also here you can see the ice drops from Mika. And can we run this again?
Oh, I have a longer one. I'll show you this later.
Ciao. Okay. Was du noch weiter?
Ja. So, and also you maybe want to read about a bit and use Google Translate to translate it to English, because the course material we worked on it to make it in English, and we want also your help. Maybe you have time for a sprint at the weekend and make a translation or documentation sprint to get all this material we have into English and maybe then later to other languages. Also, we have this duplicated because we like many places where this course material is on the net. Also, the Blender documentation with this Python API is very, very good, and also a lot of people are working there. And so what you get is we offer a platform for newbies to learn Python. And they directly learn object-oriented programming, because in Blender, everything is a visible object. You can just rotate it, you scale it, and just, but this explanation of methods is very easy, and you don't have to explain first a Hello World example. You just make things flying. And you just produce movies as a result. And you have a very different way to present also your results. You have seen, I have embedded a video in my talks. And just to make you more, or get more of your interest, there is a Blender training today after lunch. And if you like to be a trainer for PyMove 3D, it's just the only thing you need is basics of Blender. So if you take this training, you maybe are able to give a course like we did. And you find new interesting people doing so, or some students learning, starting to learn programming. It's so not a nice task to see what you can get from this. And also, we have a much longer talk about this course material and how we want to proceed tomorrow at 2:30. And last year, we had also two winners for the contest, and you can meet and talk to them at the poster session today. This was just on the beginning. And this is a submission of Mika Greif. It has had also some, you see icicles building and then falling drops. And so we want to know to give him also his prizes. So, and this will be done by Armin Stross-Hatschinski.
It works. Hi. Mika, come with me. We have some prizes for you, some placeholder prizes. We have more downstairs in a box. Gibst du dir an, okay. First of all, you get a certificate of winning the contest, and there are signatures from the members of the board of the Python Software Verband, and we give you a second one, which is a little bit stronger, for your hall of fame of all your great programs you write in the future or hidden in the past. And this is a small book about Python, which you can keep handy if you are on the road and if you want to look for some modules or something like that. This is a bigger one. And this is a book about Raspberry Pi and programming with Python, yeah? Yeah, we have a Raspberry Pi complete with additional hardware downstairs in a box. I think it's so much you cannot carry it on the stage. Do you want to say something?
Thank you, Hansas.
Thank you.
Oh, it's a quite simple statement. And I'm seeing the next generation contest winners already outside in the room. I don't look in the direction of Torben, for example. I hope you enjoyed the stuff. Do you want to say something?
Yeah. Thank you for Mika. Thank you for the audience. And we hope to have some more winners next year. And of course, Mika will continue Python and Raspberry Pi. Thank you all.